Hello champions, welcome to another episode of Risk. My name is Champion Ever and today we are playing another 6 player progressive capital conquest game which is being played on the classic Risk map with blizzards and 3 blizzards in Europe, guys. That's interesting. Okay, so which capital spot I should go? Maybe if I want to have an easy continent I should cap in Brazil. Yeah, I think I will cap in Brazil, guys, at the very least. Okay, risky move, probably says for some reason why is he saying that. Yeah, but I'm selecting South America. To go for South America, I selected my capital to be in Brazil, so I would be able to take over South America and receive +2 additional +2 troops bonus, guys. Because I saw that I do not have too many of grid options, capitals which would be connected a lot. So if I cannot be in a capital spot which would be connected a lot, then I will just go for a continent. I selected Brazil, so it would be a strong border. Okay, hope the blue player doesn't crush my 4 troops in Eastern Europe, because I will be very glad to move south. And come on, you wrong troops. I would rather wish you crushed 5 troops in Iceland. Oh well. Okay, and the blue player captures 1 more territory. Interesting. Here is my turn, and I think first of all I will discover how many troops there are in Central America, if any. Okay, the black player actually kept over here, so good to know. I will be bordering with the black player's capital. And right here, let's find out how good our capitals are. So starting from the blue player kept in Great Britain. In order to find out the connectivity rating, you have to count the territories nearest and next nearest territories combined. So the sum of the nearest and next nearest territories combined. So the blue player, yes, nearest territories are Iceland, Scandinavia and Western Europe, and the next nearest territories are Greenland and North Africa. So nearest 1, 2, 3, we've got 3 nearest territories, and 1, 2, we've got 2 next nearest territories. So if we combine 3 with 2, we've got the connectivity rating of 5, which is a relatively bad capital spot in terms of being connected, meaning what eventually later in the game the blue player could become easily card blocked. For considering right here it's 2 border Europe, maybe it will work out for the blue player well, because he would receive +5 additional troops, so as long as he successfully holds. But I'm not sure what was the plan of the white player, because he wasted a bunch of troops and left his capital with 1 troop, so yes, there will be a free capital for the purple player. Very lucky player called purple, but let's see if he takes the advantage of that or not. Yes, I see he's considering adding his troops in Ural. Okay, so let's actually find out how good the Siberian capital is. If you count the nearest territories, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and next nearest territories 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the blue player's capital gets the connectivity rating of 10, which is a much better capital than the blue player's one, and yeah, twice as good, because the blue player's connectivity rating of the capital in Great Britain is only 5. So the blue player's capital is not that good in comparison to the purple player's one. Okay, here's the question, guys. Do I want to take over South America right here or not? Maybe I will capture a territory over here now. Okay, let's end my turn. Let's see, maybe the black player wastes his troops. Because if I crush for troops, I think the black player would break from me, but maybe he would break from me at the first place. Okay, but the black player takes over the purple player's capital over here. Nice. Nice. I mean, the purple player got a white player's capital, but lost his capital in Greenland. Okay, Greenland capital connects to 1, 2, 3, 4 territories. And whose territories connect to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you combine 4 with 6, we get the connectivity rating of 10. The capital in Greenland is as good as the capital in Siberia in terms of connectivity. So it won't be that easy to card block with capitals in comparison with blue player's capital in Great Britain. Then let's find out the connectivity rating of my capital in Brazil. It connects to 1, 2, 3, 4 territories, and then if you count the next nearest territories, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes. My capital gets the connectivity rating of 9, which is worse rating than the capital in Greenland and the capital in Siberia, but still right here I'm in the 3rd place when it comes to capitals of the capitals which we already know the connectivity rating of. So let's find out the connectivity rating of Central America. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Central America gets the connectivity rating of 8. So Great Britain is the worst capital, then Central America is better, then my capital is better, it's 9, and then Greenland and Siberia gets a connectivity rating of 10. And there's one more capital, I don't know. There should be a couple of green players somewhere. Okay, I do not like what I'm getting wiped out from Asia over here. I do not have much visibility. Okay, but please attack Iceland and I'm fine. But the black player has 5 troops on his capital, so you might even consider taking over it. Blue one, yes, okay. He gets good blitz, he only lost 3 troops, so that's a very good deal for the blue player here. I think I will immediately take over South America, guys. The black player isn't using those troops right here. And I mean, if he attacks, if he breaks through Venezuela, Zell over here, then he would unleash my biggest army, my big army, my Brazilian army towards himself, so he would rather be accurate and very careful about that, as I might be mad, I might be angry and consider taking over his capital. And that would be great, guys, because, yeah, basically all of my, both of my borders would be capital borders, and okay, in response, the black player takes my 2 troops army down from Alberta, okay, which is bad, guys, because a bunch of players removing me from other places of the map. On the other hand, I think, yeah, I still have 2 troops in Japan, so I think I will add some more troops right here, so that army wouldn't get crushed as well. Okay, how many troops the green player said? 5 troops total. So he didn't take over Australia. I would assume the green player is somewhere in Australia. Okay, the white player is still in the game. He received 3 troops total. He must be the least experienced ranked player in this game, because in his very first turn, he wasted a bunch of troops and left his capital with only 1 troop to guard, and the purple player took over it easily, so I think he doesn't even know what capitals give you plus 2 troops per turn, or even what you have to take over all of the capitals in order to win a capital conquest game. So if I had to guess, I would say that the white player will be the first player to get eliminated from the game. Yeah, the leader is at 2 capitals right here. I see, guys, looking at that corner of the screen, it's the blue player. The blue player has a capital in Great Britain and in Greenland. Let's see if he breaks over, I mean, not breaks, but takes over my territory in Scandinavia. Yes, he takes those troops down. I could still break for him if I want to break Western Europe, but I think maybe I will just be good. Okay, I guess I will just, I'll add more troops over here. Let's capture a territory here, guys. Yes, I think I will leave 3 troops right here. I'm doing that troop split, guys, because I will try to move my 6 troops summit to some other area, and I would like to still have some troops in Japan. For right here, I know that somebody has a capital in Siberia, and it's a purple player. For right here, okay, the black player leaves 4 troops in Alaska, so I think he clearly shows what he would like to go for North America. He would like to eventually take over the capital in Greenland as well, so I think I won't bother. The black player, especially when he lets me hold South America, he could break through 1 troop border right here, but he doesn't, so I want to show him some appreciation, and I will move my troops out of Kamchatka. I think he crushed my 2 troops in Alberta back then for a reason. He wants to clearly show what he wants to go for North America. So I won't bother it comes to that. He white player has his troops right here. I was the last troops of the white player, guys. Again, he's doing one roll, he should have done the blitz here, because the percent, the success blitzing chance was above 50%, but okay, he switches to the blitz option when the blitz roll is unfavorable, but still makes it. And okay, I saw the dust movement after he made that attack, guys, so the white player still has troops somewhere else as well. The purple player received 5 troops total. Yes, the purple player still has a scapula in Siberia, nothing else. Okay, 12 troops received by the blue player. The blue player has Europe and 2 capitals, which are in Greenland, in Great Britain. Okay, well played, the white player says so, and the green player sent an angry emote, so what does? Okay, so yeah, the blue player skipped. The blue player skipped his card in order to not receive the lowest amount of troops, because this game is being played with progressive cards, and the first trade in will only be 4 troops. So if you're one of the first players, and it can usually be worth for you to skip your 5th card when it comes to the first round of sets, and especially if you have a continent. So if all of us were skipping cards, it will mostly benefit the blue player and me, because we're players who have continent. Okay, the green player right here, at the least he has some troops. He received, okay, 7 troops total, so I think he took over Australia. And who knows, maybe he's even taking over Africa over here. Okay, three troops received by the white player. Let's see, where is he going to add those two? Okay, he is capturing territories. I see, yeah, yeah, I see the dice movement, so it's not next to me. Okay, right here, I saw that he tried taking over North Africa, so good. Good to know that the white player has some troops in Africa as well. For right here, it's just at 4 cards, so I won't be looking up for the white player. It wouldn't be worth for me to go try eliminating him just for 4 troops, man. I would lose even more troops. Okay, the purple players. Then, yeah, 5 troops total, guys. I mean, makes sense because, yeah. Australia belong to the green player. Europe belong to the blue player. And also, the blue player has a couple in Greenland. So, the black player won't take over North America, to the least. As of now, then, I see that there's a territory in Africa, so nobody took over Africa. Well, I saw that the white player tried attacking North Africa, so I know that the green player didn't take over it. And right here, obviously, I have some troops in Asia. So I know that nobody holds Asia either. Okay, let's capture a territory now. And, okay, 16 troops. 16 troops there are of the purple player. Yes, I'm leaving 3 troops some in Japan, guys, to sort of have still an army over here, and then I will be moving up closer to Africa or something. So I just hope that the black player doesn't decide to crush my troops here. Yeah, I'm not sure what's the problem with the black player, guys. Yeah, the black player apparently hates me. That's weird, considering the blue player took over his capital in Greenland. So if I was the black player, then I would be mad on the blue player rather than on me, on the red player. But I mean, in other hand, it makes game to be more interesting right here, because, yeah, the black player basically will force me to block my army in Brazil over here. Okay, the green player still received 7 troops total. He only has Australia captured. He didn't take over. The white player is a draft phase, taking a lot of time to make his turn, so I think that's even possible, but he just decides to quit the game. Yeah, I think he disconnects right here. Yeah, the green player is in an angry mode, doesn't appreciate the white player taking his time, but I think the white player already closed the game. Yeah, so the white player ended up completely skipping his turn, and now it says that he is offline. The purple player is 5 troops total. Yeah, makes sense. Yeah, makes sense. Here we're basically going to receive the same number of troops like we do in every turn, so unless something drastically changes, but I really doubt that. But the purple player is capturing more territories right here, and well played the green player says, so that's interesting. That's interesting, guys. Here blue player will receive 8 troops, and I will receive 10. I'll receive 10 after trading set. Card value right here still isn't relatively high, so eliminations aren't worth, so unless maybe somebody gets a white player easily. Here blue player discovers my 30 troops capital army over here. Okay, please do not block. Yeah, go back to Europe. Okay, let's trade in a set. Let's trade in a set, guys. I mean, should I go for a white player? His territories might only be in Africa and Asia. And I would receive 12 troops. 12 troops, Yeah, I'm not sure if it's worth it. Okay, let's actually take over East Africa right here. Okay, let's go to eliminate the white player. Hopefully, we will get him. Okay, the purple player is actually weak too. Weak too. Yeah, actually, I'm splitting those troops over here. I do not like that too much. Okay, not 100%, 93. Okay, but I still make it. Nice. I think I will go for the purple player as well, guys. Yeah, let's trade in a set. I think I want some more troops in India. Or maybe not. Okay, let's capture a territory here, guys. Let's capture the purple player's capital easily. Okay, 12 troops lost. I mean, that's not many. 4 troops more. Okay, and wow. Wow, I'm getting the purple player easily right here as well. Wow, I didn't even expect to make that elimination, guys. So does that mean that I can eliminate the green player easily as well, guys? Okay, good game. Well played, says. Okay, thank you. Black. Yeah, should put troops here. Okay, I won't put my troops to North Africa. I'll put them right here. Take over those territories right here. Yes, I think I'm getting the green player as well, so unless he still has some territories in North America, but no. Okay, and he even had a wild card. Nice. Okay, I think I want to add more troops here, guys, a little bit, but just a little bit. I've led the rest of my troops over here, and let's go break through North. I mean, let's block the black player over here, possibly. I mean, he can break through Venezuela, but if he does so, then he blocks his capital army for me, but okay, he does have a set, which is very fortunate. He has a set at 3 cards. Oh well. Well, at the very least, he trades it in immediately, so right here he will be without. I know that he won't trade in any set in a few following turns, so that's good to know. And while he can break through my continents, he cannot take over any of my capitals now. Yeah, but that was super amazing, guys. I only went to possibly eliminate a white player, but I ended up eliminating even 3 players. White, purple, and green. And I, at first, I even even hesitated eliminating white player from the game. I thought, why not, why not? He now a bunch of troops received by the blue player. Let's see if he blitzes my capital, will he port or will he fortify his troops back? I hope he fortifies his troops back. Okay, let's see. Okay, no, okay, nice. He go right here and please take over the, I mean, just please crush the black player's troops. It's not a capital, but please just crush troops. Yeah, good thing that the blue player ended up blocking his troops right here. That's good. Right here, I can trade an asset. I could trade an asset, but do I really want that, guys? Probably not. Okay, so I'll make sure to strengthen this capital a little bit more, I guess. A territory here, I mean, on the other hand, the blue player might consider taking over my cap, guys, one of my capture, if I like. If he does so, then, oh well, oh well. Give black player adds troops in Australia and fortifies them to Siam. Let's see if the blue player trades an asset right now or not. I'm kind of tended to wipe out the black player from Australia and Asia and then put a bigger army in Kamchatka, so yeah, but then I would also need to put some more troops in Venezuela, I guess. Okay, let's see if the blue player will take over Africa. Okay. Well, the black player hesitates to breaking through Venezuela, guys. I think if I break through the blue player and leave his capital barely unguarded, then the black player wouldn't see it. But okay, the blue player puts a bunch of troops over here. So does that mean that he left his capital in Greenland or Great Britain relatively unguarded? Let's actually trade an asset, guys, and I think I would like to check out. Okay, 230 troops, guys. I think I will take over this capital. Okay, nice. Good blitz. Okay, and he doesn't even got his capital over here. Okay, let's take over it easily. Nice. Okay, well, right here, the black player might take over my... Well, I hope that right here he has his army in Central America locked, but he has Western United States and Eastern United States territories captured. But right here, he has an army in Siam, so he could go through those territories to take over my Siberian. Yeah, the blue player might consider taking my capital in Brazil, but right here, he would become kinda locked. Okay, the black player goes right here. Let's see if he blitzes. I hope he loses a bunch of troops, but let's see. Okay, no, he didn't lose that many troops, but oh well, oh well. What will the blue player do? Will he take over my capital in Brazil or not? Yes, he added more troops, he added 3 troops, but okay, I see he's capturing a territory elsewhere. Okay, 15 troops, wow, that's a lot. I guess I will strengthen both those capitals over here, and I will capture a territory over here. I think that Australian capital is the worst one. Okay, black player adds more troops in Central America, and okay, no, he goes right here in Eastern United States. Okay, captures Quebec. Okay, and sees what I have 20 troops in Greenland, so I don't think he will go for it. Okay, and let's find out the connectivity rating of the capital of New Guinea. It connects to 1, 2, 3 territories, and then those territories connect to one more territory, so it gets the connectivity rating of 4, which is the worst capital in this specific game. The only other worst capital is a capital in Great Britain. Okay, the blue player goes right here. Okay, I'm even happy because right here he will be next to the black player. Okay, he even takes over the black player's capital. Okay, I will say, well played. Okay, will he go? Yes, he goes from my capital as well, guys. Okay, I mean, that's a mistake. You should look forward to eliminate the black player from the game completely. Yeah, because he cannot go for all of the capitals, and yeah, he have probably gone for it. Okay, what do I do here, guys? What do here? Okay, let's actually strengthen this capital, guys, because I could get eliminated myself as well. Let's try taking over this capital, and okay, actually, I won't even got this capital because right here someone will very take easily over it anyway. Okay, so I just hope that the black player doesn't go for my capital right here in the game. Okay, he doesn't. Hope he goes back to retaliate to the blue player. Okay, he takes over that capital in Brazil easily. So this is why I didn't leave those troops in Brazil, because right here I knew what those troops would be crushed. Well, right here there's a chance that the black player will still let me have those 4 troops in Peru. Yeah, but this game is interesting, guys. This game is synced. Okay, do I have a set? I think, yeah, I do have a set, but I think at this moment it doesn't even matter if I do, because most players have already traded in their sets, and nobody would have enough accessible troops to take my capital down and then finish eliminating me from the game. The question is, how do I play this? Okay, I would receive 5 troops, I mean, plus 2 right here, so plus 57, I wouldn't be able to go for the capitals run. Okay, other players wouldn't be able to trade in their set, so I think I might not even trade in my set right here. Okay, so that capital in Central America belongs to the black player, I see. Yeah, and that must mean that the black player has, I mean, besides him having his capital in Siberia, he also has a capital in Great Britain, because right here I see what the leader is at 4 capital. capitals. So the blue players just has one capital over here and might be a very easy target, guys. I think I might eliminate the blue player from the game and right here, yes please, capture Mongolia, so this way I will be able to go to eliminate the blue player from the game using my army in New Guinea. Yes, the black player is playing right here aggressive. Yeah, he's swiping me out, but I mean he's leaving few troops on his capital, fewer troops on his capitals. Okay, yes, please capture and please leave no troops. Just leave one troop. Okay, but my troops is set by the blue player. So how did he get that many troops? Here's the question. Because I mean three territorial troops, then plus two for his capitals, so five. And he received nine, so plus four. Plus four, where did he get? Does he still have a lot of territories, which I know, but I mean that would require a lot of territories. Okay, never mind. Let's trade him. Okay, or maybe right here, see. Yeah, maybe he still has a bunch of territories right here, guys. Okay, but we will check out. I know that the blue player doesn't have any territories in South America. Okay, yeah, here is the black player's capital. Yes, I will just go strictly to eliminate the blue player from the game. Okay, 100% blitz, let's go. And yes, the blue player has been eliminated from the game. I will trade an asset. Yes, and I think... Okay, well played, well played. Thanks. Yeah, the black player is the most decent player in this game, guys. He's smart. I'm in the endgame. If it's two-player endgame. Okay, let's actually take over this capital, guys. Nice. And let's take over this capital. Nice as well. Okay, and right here, yeah, I realize that I... Yeah, I'm a little bit misled right here. I realize that I will leave one capital with only troop. With only one troop, so that was a little bit of a misplay for me. And right here, a little bit run out of time. But yeah, considering I've got an easy capital from the blue play in Central America, that doesn't too much matter. And right here, this capital is really blocked, guys. That capital is really blocked, so in case the black player puts a bunch of troops over here, and it will be really helpful. And why? Why, black, you haven't even break through Europe and Africa? I mean, at the least through Africa, because, I mean, you know what, there's a capital in Great Britain, but why didn't you break through? Why didn't you break through the rest? Okay, I mean, do I win right here, guys? Do I win right here? Let's trade in a set, guys. Okay, we'll add a little bit over here, and let's see. Let's see, actually, what kind of blitz roll it is. 98% blitz. Let's go. Okay, let's go blitzing this capital over here. Nice blitz. And yes, the last capital left, guys. Do we win? Okay, 15. And it is 100% blitz. Let's go. We win. We win, and we do not even let the black player to trade in a set. Wow, that's a nice victory, isn't it, guys? Yeah, and that was a very fun game. What I'm gonna say, that was a very fun game.